Hi mga ka-chordates! It's me, Sir Yong! So the content of this video, it talks about the characteristics of life. Yes, bakit life, sir? Kasi nga diba sabi nila, ang buhay mahalaga. So there is a lot of definition of life in the internet. Isa na doon is live life to the fullest. So in biology naman, terms it contains or it's something to have in children that can pass or that can inherit their genetic information to their offspring. But for me, life is from birth to death. Yun yung definition ko ng life. But we're not going to focus to the definition of life. Let's focus to the characteristics of life. So there are 9 characteristics of life. Yes. 9 po siya. But don't worry, I will give you a mnemonics. Ano yung mnemonics, sir? It is one of the technique of the teachers para mabilis maintindihan at para mabilis ma-familiarize ang topic ng mga estudyante. So, are you familiar with the ABC song? Yes! A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, Z, hanggang letter Z po siya. But don't worry, hindi po tayo aabot sa letter Z. Hanggang I lang po tayo kasi there are 9 characteristics lang po ang life. So, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I. So, 9 lang po siya lahat. A stands for adaptation. B stands for breeding. C stands for cells. D stands for different levels of organization. E stands for energy. F stands for food. G stands for growth and development. H stands for homeostasis. And I stands for irritability. Yun po ang 9 characteristics of life. Now, isa-isahin na po natin siya. Una is adaptation. Adaptation by its definition, it is a process of change in which an organism or a particular species can better suited to its environment. Now, that's definition is appropriate for the higher levels. But how about for the lower grades? Most especially the grade 1 and the grade 2. So we are going to use this definition, adaptation, or ito yung ginagamit kong term ng adaptation para lubos mo nawaan ng mga, most especially the lower grades. So, para sa akin, adaptation, it refers to the ability of the living things to adjust to the different condition of its environment or in the environment. So, the keyword there is adjust. Oh, you need to adjust in order for you to survive. Ika nga, sabi nila. So, like for example, nowadays, yung pandemic na tinatawag natin sa COVID-19. So, kailangan natin mag-adjust. May tinatawag tayong new normal na dinatawag. So, yung normal, yung new normal na yun, sinasabi natin, kailangan natin mag-adjust to the environment para mabuhay or in order for us to survive para hindi tayo mamatay because of that COVID. So, kailangan natin sumunod sa protocol. So, yun po yung adaptation. The keyword there is to adjust. Okay. But, there are 3 types of adaptation. First is the structural adaptation. Second is the behavioral adaptation. And the third is the physiological adaptation. Now, isa-isahin natin ang different kinds of adaptation. Okay, the first one is the structural adaptation. So, ang structural adaptation, it talks about the body parts and coloring that can aid for the animals to survive. So, the best example of the structural adaptation is the camouflage. So, from the word camouflage, so makikita natin na nagbi-blend siya sa environment in order for that particular species to survive against sa kanyang predator, di ba? Nagbi-blend siya sa environment para hindi siya makain ng predator. So, yan yung structural adaptation. Ginagamit nila yung body parts nila, ginagamit yung kulay nila para mag-blend doon sa environment. And there are many examples of structural adaptation. Isa na doon is their teeth, their body movements, at saka their body colors. So, yun po ang example ng structural adaptation. Second type of adaptation is behavioral adaptation. It is an action that aids for survival. The best example here is hibernation and migration. So, ang pinakasikat sa hibernation is the polar bear. So, before pa man dumating ang winter season, kumakain na ng marami ang polar bear in order for them to survive. Kasi pag dumating ang winter season, hindi na po sila makaka-find ng pagkain or makakahanap ng pagkain kasi nga, it's too cold to the environment at saka, konti na lang ang available na food sa environment kasi nga taglamig siya. So kaya naga-hibernate siya, natutulog siya para less lang ang energy na magagamit niya in order for them to survive. So yan yung behavioral adaptation. Third is physiological adaptation. It is a job of the body parts controlling the life processes that can aid for survival. The best example here is snake making a venom. So, nagsisecrets ngayon ng venom ang snake in order for them to escape or to attack those predator na para hindi siya makain. So, yun yung parang defense mechanism niya para mabuhay. So, in order for the snake to survive. So, gumagamit siya ngayon ng venom. So, yun po ang physiological adaptation. Again, so, in adaptation, the keyword there is to adjust, merong tatlong types of adaptation. Structural, behavioral, and physiological. So let's move now to the second characteristic of life, which is letter B, which means breeding. So breeding, or in other words, that is reproduction. So we know already that in order for the organisms to survive, they need to reproduce para hindi sila ma-extinct, di ba? So there are two types of reproduction. First is the asexual reproduction at saka ang second is the sexual reproduction. Pag sinabi nating asexual reproduction, it contains one parent. Yes, single parent lang po siya. And their offspring are genetically identical to their parents. So in other words, their offspring are called clone. So clone po nila ang kanilang offspring. So example there are the hydra, the sea star, the bacteria, what else? The euglena, the paramecium. So yun yung example ng asexual reproduction. Now let's proceed now to the sexual reproduction. Kapag sinabi natin sexual reproduction, it talks about the two parents. Yes po, merong mother at saka may father. So their genes are not identically as their parents kasi nagmix na po sila. So they are not, their offspring are not identical to their parents. And also the sexual reproduction is highly diverse, more kumpara sa asexual reproduction. So ang example ng sexual reproductions are the flowering plants, the humans, the dogs, the chicken, the birds, and so on. The third characteristics of life is letter C, which means cells. So cells is the basic functional unit of life. So ika nga sabi nila, living things are made up of cells. Pero in this video, hindi natin i-cover up lahat ng cells kasi ang haba po talaga siya. Sa college nga, 6 months or 1 sem po ang cellular and molecular biology na subject. So hindi po kaya talagang ma-insert in this video. So sa next na lang natin na vlog. So ang gagawin na lang po natin ngayon is the cellular theory na lang po tayo. At kung sino yung mga proponent sa cells. So, let's talk about the cellular theory timeline. So, nagsimula po siya in 1590 by Hans and Zacharias Jensen na sila po ang kauna-unang nag-produce ng first compound microscope. Tapos, after that one, in 1665, si Robert Hooke po ang kauna-unahang nag-use na term na cell kasi in his study, kumuha po siya ng isang patay na dahon and then view niya po under the microscope. Ang nakita niya po doon is maliliit na square. So, para siyang selda. So, since nakita, na-observe niya na parang selda, so tinerm niya yon and each selda na yon is tinerm niya as cells. Kaya, nabuo yung term na cell. So, next naman is in 1685, Anton van Leeuwenhoek, siya po ang kauna-unahang nag-view ng living cells under a simple microscope. So, since si Robert Hooke ang nag-view or nag coined sa term na cells, si Anton van Leeuwenhoek naman ang kauna-unahang na-view ng living cells, buhay po na cells, under a simple microscope. Fast forward po tayo, in 1838, Matthias Sliden, he is a botanist that have an interest in the cellular theory. So, he proposed that all types or all forms of plants are made up of cells. Tapos, in 1839 naman, si Theodore Swan, he is also an gusto niya din malaman about sa cellular theory. So, he proposed also, he is a zoologist that he proposed that all forms of animals are made up of cells. Tapos, in 1855, si Rudolf Virchow, siya ang nag-state na, or siya ang nagsabi na, all forms of life, all forms of cells are made up of pre-existing cells. So, hindi to mabubuo ang isang cell kapag wala yung cell. So, nagdi-divide lang daw yun. So, yun po ang cellular theory timeline. So, from 1590, which is from Hans, tapos Zacharias Janssen, na nakabuo ng simple micro or compound microscope, to Robert Hooke, to Anton van Leeuwenhoek, to Matthias Sliden, tapos Theodore Swan, at saka si Rudolf Virchow. So, yun po ang cellular theory na timeline. The fourth characteristic of life is letter D, which means the different levels of organization. Yes, meron pong different levels of organization, at saka merong 12 levels of organization. Tama po ang yung rinig, 12 po yun. So, mahaba-haba siya, marami siya, but don't worry, I will give you also a mnemonics para mabilis nyo ma-familiarize siya. So, ang mnemonics na ginawa na to is hindi nang galing sa akin. Of course, hindi naman ako matalino. So, nakuha ko na mnemonics na to nung nag-review pa ako sa board exam. Nakuha ko siya kay Ma'am Vanessa sa CBRC nung nag-review pa ako way back 2017 ata yun. Oo. So, ginamit ko siya as mnemonics kapag nagtuturo ako, kapag most especially kapag ang topic is different levels of organization na. So, kapag yun nga, kapag ginamit mo ang mnemonics, ang estudyante talaga tuwang-tuwa, tapos mas mabilis nilang ma-memorize. So, the mnemonics of the different levels of organization is AMOC, T-O-O-O, POCO, ECHO, BB. So, sounds weird, pero best po siya na mnemonics para sa akin, para mabilis siyang ma-memorize ng mga estudyante. Para mabilis mo nawaan kung ano yung mga different levels of organization. Kasi nga, 12 po yun. So, A or A stands for atomic level. So, we know that the atom is the smallest unit of an element that can still maintain its property as an element. So, example of the atomic level or example of the atom is the hydrogen, the carbon, the oxygen, and many more. Next naman, yung mo of the AMOC, T-O-O-O, POCO, ECHO, BB is the molecular level. Yes, atom plus atom, if we combine it together, we form as a molecules that which their property are different from each other element. So, example of this is, a water. Example is the DNA and also the carbon dioxide. So, sa carbon dioxide, we can find it dalawang element, the carbon at saka the oxygen. One atom of the carbon and two atoms of the oxygen. So, if we combine it together, we form now a molecule that called a carbon dioxide. Next naman is the cells. Cells is the basic functional unit of life. Now, through that molecules, kapag nag-bind at saka nag-bind together, tapos it can perform a specific task, we form now a cellular level. So, ano yung mga examples ng cells? So, meron tayong epithelial cells, meron tayong muscle cells, at saka meron tayong neuron cells. So, after the cellular level, move tayo sa next level, which is the tissue. Tissue level. So, tissue is a group of cells combined together to form a specific task. Okay. So, example of the tissue level are epithelial tissue, connective tissue, muscular tissue, and many more. So, next naman, after the tissue level, we form now the organ level. So, two or more tissues bind together to complete a particular task or to complete a particular function, we form now the organs. So, ang example ng organs are heart, the brain, the stomach, and many more. So, after the organ level is the organ system. So, kapag rumami na yung organs, so ang tawag po doon is the organ system. And we have now an example of an organ system. Yung digestive system, yung mga system sa katawan natin or yung body system. The muscular system, skeletal system, nervous system, lymphatic system, and many more. So, after that one, if we are done in the, we call this one, organ system level, proceed na agad sa organismal level or organism. So, kapag rumami yung mga system sa katawan, we form now an organism. So, example, there are the humans. So, after that one, kapag rumami yung humans, meron po tayong or magiging, ano na po siya, population. So, after ng population, community na po siya. After pag rumami po yung community, ang tawag po doon is ecosystem. So, under the ecosystem, meron pong tinatawag na biomes. Like for example, yung tundra, the taiga, desert, and many more. Tapos, after that one, the last level is the biosphere, in which all the living things on the earth interacted to each other. So, yun yung biosphere. Again, the different levels of organizations are the atomic level, molecular level, cellular level, tissue level, organ level, organ system level, organism level, population, community, ecosystem, biomes, and biosphere. So, yun po ang 12 different levels of organization. The number 5 characteristic of life is energy. But the number 5 and the number 6 is connected to each other kasi the number 6 is the food. So, without the food, we don't have an energy. Kasi sabi nga, energy is ability to do work. So, sa energy, kailangan ang metabolism. So, metabolism, it is a chemical reaction that involves in maintaining the living state of the cell. So, meron tayong narinig na chemical reaction. So, sino yung mag-react doon? So, gagamit siya ngayon ng enzymes. So, ang enzymes, it is to speed up the chemical reactions to place into the cell. So, para mapabilis ang kanyang chemical reaction, gagamit siya na protein na enzymes. So, meron tayong tinatawag na two types of metabolism. The anabolism at saka catabolism. Yung anabolism is to synthesize all the compound needs by the cell, or in other words, siya yung build-up process. While sa catabolism naman, from the word cut, so ibig sabihin to break down the molecules in order to obtain the energy na kailangan sa cell. So again, sa metabolism, may dalawang types. Anabolism at saka catabolism. Dapat tandaan, anabolism, build-up, catabolism, breakdown. The number 6 of the characteristics of life is the letter F, which means the food. So, there are 4 macromolecules in our body. First is the carbohydrates, second is the protein, third is the lipids, and last is the nucleic acid. So, let's go first to the carbohydrates. Carbohydrates is the energy source of our body. And there are 3 types of carbohydrates: monosaccharides, disaccharides, and polysaccharides. When we talk about monosaccharide, it means only one sugar, and there are 3 examples of it. First is the glucose, second is the fructose, and third is the galactose. Saan po natin makikita ang glucose? The best example there is in the dextrose. So, mapapansin po natin kapag yung isang pasyente na nasa hospital, nilalagyan ng suero or yung dextrose na tinatawag because that dextrose contains the glucose which can maintain the energy of the person kahit hindi po sila kumakain. Next example naman is the fructose. So, saan makikita? Doon po sa mga fruits. Next is the galactose. So, makikita po natin siya sa mga milk. Second type of carbohydrates is disaccharides. Disaccharide, which means two sugar. And there are three examples. The sucrose, the lactose, and the maltose. When we talk about the sucrose, that is a combination of the glucose and the fructose. So, the best example of sucrose is the table sugar. Yung nakikita natin sa bahay na mga asukal. Next naman is the lactose. The combination of the lactose is one glucose and one a galactose. So, the best example of the lactose is the milk sugar. Next and the last is the maltose. Maltose is a combination of glucose plus glucose. So, the best example there is the beer sugar. Or third type of carbohydrates is the polysaccharides. So, polysaccharides, which means complex sugar. So, ibig sabihin, it contains two or more sugar po siya. The best example of polysaccharides is the starch and also the cellulose. Second macromolecules in our body is the protein. The primary function of the protein is for movement, for defense, and also for growth and repair. The building block of protein is amino acid. The third macromolecules in our body is lipids. The primary function of the lipids is to store the energy and also for insulation. The building blocks of lipids is fatty acid. Fourth macromolecules in our body is the nucleic acid. The building block of nucleic acid is nucleotides, and its primary function is to transfer the genetic information. So, meron po tayong tinatawag dyan na DNA and RNA. DNA, or deoxyribonucleic acid, contains double strand and absent po sa kanya ang uracil. So, meron po siyang tinatawag na nitrogenous base, which are the adenine, which paired with the thymine, guanine, which paired with the cytosine. On the other hand, the RNA, or the ribonucleic acid, contains the ribose sugar, only a single strand, and the thymine is absent. So, the nitrogenous base of the RNA are the adenine, which paired with the uracil, and guanine, which paired with the cytosine. The number 7 of the characteristics of life is letter G, which means growth and development. Of course, the living things are capable enough to grow and to develop. But remember, growth is different from the development. Kapag sinabi po natin growth, it talks about the number. So, ibig sabihin, quantitative po siya. Sinabi natin development, it talks about the quality. So, ibig sabihin, qualitative measure po ang ginagamit kapag to identify the development of the living things. Number 8 of the characteristics of life is the letter H, which means the homeostasis. Homeostasis, it is a self-regulating process by which an organism tends to maintain stability to adjust to a specific environment. So, yun po. So, the best example po dyan is the body temperature. Number 9 of characteristics of life is letter I, which means irritability. So, irritability, it is the ability of the cell to receive and respond to its stimulus. So, the keyword there is to respond to its stimulus. So, like for example, yung makahiya or the mimosa pudica. So, kapag tinatch po natin yung makahiya plant, di ba, nagre-respond agad siya sa kanyang environment. So, ang tawag po doon na response is the thigmotropism. So it's a lack of ability that a particular living things can respond to its stimulus. So isa na nga po doon ang thigmotropism. So meron din po tayong tinatawag na chemotropism. So it responds naman din po siya sa chemicals. Yun po ang 9 characteristics of life. So I hope that you've learned a lot on this video, and if you have any suggestions, you are freely to comment po sa comment section. And if you like this video, please don't forget to click the subscribe button and the notification bell. See you sa next vlog natin, mga ka-Cornay!